Back to all of the weather that we have been having lately. The huge scare at Oroville Dam sure has a lot of people concerned about whether California can handle more rain.
Well, KPIX 5's Wilson Walker on the lessons learned and what experts say needs to happen now to prevent future flood disasters.
This is not normal. A big cement just blew off.
It's getting worse.
It was an incredible story.
The inspector might have, missed a little patch.
On one hand, a textbook lesson in the power of small problems.
We still have some room to absorb the water coming in.
Small problems that can quickly turn into catastrophe.
What we saw was a series of cascading failures.
And in that respect, the crisis here at the Oroville Dam can teach us a larger lesson about the state of California's water infrastructure. It's an aging system. It has to work perfectly. And the smallest crack, the smallest mistake can lead to tremendous problems.
We have old thinking about infrastructure. We have old infrastructure that needs to be inspected and maintained.
And that's the first problem. A lot of this stuff is old. Hetch Hetchy was flooded in the 1920s. Shasta Dam built in the 30s. Oroville's relatively young at 1968.
And off there is the highest dam in the United States.
I mean, to some degree, we have a problem of the success of the previous generation's infrastructure building.
Jay Lund is a professor of civil engineering at UC Davis.
They did such a good job that we haven't had to put as many of our best people and as much of our best money into that as the previous generation did when it was first built.
We built a lot of infrastructure in the 20th century.
Dr. Peter Glick studies California water for the Pacific Institute.
That infrastructure was built assuming the climate wasn't going to change, and that assumption we now know is no longer true.
Not even a year ago, I was standing at Lake Oroville reporting on the disappointing performance of El Nino, and after those brutally dry years, everyone was understandably in conservation mode.
Because it's just been a drought. You're trying to capture all that water. You don't want to lose it.
But then we need to turn on a dime and move record amounts of rainfall, and these dams weren't really built for that kind of agility.
I think part of our challenge in the 21st century is redesigning our flood system to accept more flood risk and reduce the population's at exposure from these extreme events.
And we know how to do this. In fact, we're doing it right now at Folsom Dam, where they're about to finish work on a second spillway. Now, because those new gates sit 50 feet below the original gates, the lake level can be brought lower sooner, meaning they can make room for big storms before the water even starts climbing towards the top of the dam.
That was a new way of thinking about infrastructure that lets us deal with more extreme weather.
It was also extremely difficult. Upgrading Folsom Dam took 10 years and almost $1 billion, and it might not have happened without another American flood disaster.
Katrina did more good for California flood control than any other storm we've had in a long time.
Hurricane Katrina prompted an extensive repair of the levees protecting Sacramento, but our levee danger hardly ends at the American River.
You know, this is probably one of the bigger cracks we've seen where the levee didn't actually fail.
We have levee risks, we have flood risks. The Delta's a problem.
And most of California's water problems do eventually run through the Delta, where an earthquake or a flood could leave two-thirds of the state with no water. Now, if you're thinking that fixing all of this and paying for all of it is somehow unimaginable, try to imagine for a moment what almost happened in Oroville.
Essentially, what we're looking at is approximately a 30-foot wall of water.
You hope not to have too much failure, but you often need a little bit of failure in order to do the right thing and come back.
And the more we step back and look at things, the more apparent it becomes that we need to rethink water top to bottom.
Increasingly, we will want to sort of step back and say, okay, let's rethink the whole system.
And in the long run, concrete fails. And if we can think about a broader way of managing our water for the 21st century, we'll be much better off.
In the Sacramento San Joaquin Delta, Wilson Walker, KPIX 5.